35, it's still South Bramble ball.
Back goes Schmidt, Rose, passes Carr, Long breaks out of the tackle in the 5, touchdown Orange! Alex Long with his 3rd career touchdown. Jackson Schmidt, 3-step drop, can't find anyone open now, launches at the end zone, hold in by Alex Long, touchdown Orange!
Low snap, it bounces to him, the ball is free, and LeMaster nearly blocked it, and now it's taken by an up back at the 40, to the 45-yard line, over the 50, 45 to the 40, this is Beasley to the 20, 15, 10, 5, Martavius Beasley with a touchdown!
Jackson Schmidt, Alex Long,
right pocket,
Martavius Beasley!
Touchdown Orange!
This is Orange High School Football on HillsboroSports.com, the home of Hillsboro Sports. Tonight's broadcast is brought to you by Okinichi Golf Course. Come and meet me at Okinichi. Handy Andy's. It's not your everyday convenience store. It's Handy Andy's. By Jay's Chicken Shack. Taste their delicious deep-pressure fried chicken and pitas on North Churton Street. Happy Stitches, located in the Daniel Boone Village for all your embroidery needs. Carden's Body and Paint Shop, located on Highway 157 in Caldwell for over 30 years. Visit Greg, William, Dennis, and John today. Hilltopper Lacrosse, the premier traveling lacrosse program in Orange County. Visit HilltopperLAX.com. By the Flower Patch in Hillsboro. Send a little sunshine today. Goss Water Pump Specialists, serving all your water pump needs. And the Deer Pushers Association of America, killing tomorrow's trophies today. Now, let's go live to the stadium to Jamie Hall and the voice of HillsboroSports.com, Jeff Hamlin.
It was 2 years ago on this very field between these two very teams that Orange and Chapel Hill played a classic. And words can't express how good Chapel Hill looked that night against the Panthers in a game where first place was on the line in the Big 8 Conference. It was a different league then, and Chapel Hill had a 31-10 lead at one point against Orange, but the Panthers had Bryce Wilson. And Bryce came up huge once again that night, as he would so many times throughout his Orange career. Only as a sophomore, Wilson would score a touchdown and then recover the ensuing onside kick that led to Tay Jones scoring on a reverse, and the Panthers managed to stun the Tigers coming from behind in fashion here at Allman Stadium. But just a month later, that Chapel Hill team that fell short that night would go on to upset Southern Durham at Southern, and they were one game away from playing for the state championship at Keenan Stadium. Ultimately, they lost out to the team that defeated Orange and the team that would eventually win the 3AA state championship that year in Northern Guilford. Fast forward 2 years and things are considerably different, at least on Chapel Hill's end. The Tigers are struggling while Orange is moving on. They have a 9-0 record. They are perfect in Big 8 play, and they are searching for their first ever undefeated regular season. And here tonight on Homecoming 2016, the Panthers and the Tigers, two Orange County rivals, will lock horns once again. And good evening here from Allman Stadium. This is Jeff Hamlin here with you on HillsboroSports.com. Jamie Hall hopefully will join us a little bit later on as we gear up for Orange versus Chapel Hill tonight. The Tigers are winless in conference play. They are 0-4 in league play after having lost to Cedar Ridge to open its conference schedule. Last week they wound up losing to Northern Vance, and unfortunately it's been a numbers game that Coach Isaac Marsh has had to deal with and really has suffered with, to be quite honest, because the Tigers just got a JV team together during the fourth game of the season for their game against East Chapel Hill. In fact, Chapel Hill's only wins this year, they have only two. They defeated East Chapel Hill and they defeated Carrboro. This game is essentially for the Orange County Championship, as Chapel Hill wound up defeating the two other teams from the Chapel Hill-Carrboro City School System. And, of course, last week Orange defeated its crosstown rival in the Orange County system, the Cedar Ridge Red Wolves, in decisive fashion over at Cedar Ridge High School. For Orange tonight, they're looking for more consistency from their offense. Jackson Schmidt was stellar once again last week. He threw for 157 yards and 2 touchdowns. That's his second best mark of the year. He completed 4 passes, but the big plays were there for the Panthers, namely from Peyton Wilson. Also, Cody Evans had a huge catch in the game, his first 100-yard receiving game of his career. And he also wound up getting a good game from Mervonte Beasley, did Schmidt. So Orange comes in as the heavy favorite tonight here at home, and Orange simply has to win out against two opponents they'll be heavily favored against in order to